Hey there. Thanks for joining me today. Thanks for watching this video. I wanted to go over a couple things. I don't know if my viewers out there have noticed the severity of the storms that have happened or if they've happened where you live or in your neck of the woods. But the reason we're seeing these storms and flooding and record snowfalls, drought and all this is because of climate change. And one of the things with climate change is the atmosphere warms. It warms the oceans, it warms the land, it warms the lakes. You get more evaporation. For every degree Celsius that the atmosphere warms, it holds roughly 7% more moisture. And with that, you get these rain events where just today, actually, Nova Scotia and Canada had 3 months worth of rain in just 24 hours. There was flooding, people lost their lives. And again, people ask themselves, and I ask myself and people I know, what can I do to help combat climate change? People say, oh, stop burning fossil fuels, go this way, go that way. That is good. If you can afford an electric car or solar, I have solar on my house. I drive an electric car. I also have gasoline and diesel cars. I have a lot of vehicles. The biggest change you can make, the biggest benefit you can do, and anybody can do it, is really to cut back or ideally eliminate animal products from your diet. That's milk, eggs, cheese, so dairy, meat, any kind of meat, and really cut that out of your diet. That's going to be the biggest impact any one individual can have to help combat climate change. Not everybody has the luxury of getting an electric car or having solar power or not flying and all these things, transportation wise, it's not realistic or even reachable for so many people, but just cutting meat and dairy out of your diet is. And a lot of people, I've heard people recently say, oh, that's for wealthy people. And, the thing is, in times of need, like in the Great Depression in the 1920s, people actually cut out meat and dairy and that stuff because it was so expensive. The things they could afford were rice, beans, flour, those foods that you make foods out of. And nowadays, there are so many available options for great foods, and they're really affordable. I went to the dollar store just down the street here and found Beyond Burgers, two patties for $1.25. They also had eight of the Beyond sausage patties, breakfast sausage patties, again, for $1.25. There's various stores that have it. The more processed foods you buy, the more expensive it is. If you can afford to buy the base ingredients to make stuff, that's when it really pays to be vegan. And it's a lot less than buying meat and dairy and also cruelty-free. You're not hurting any animals. Another video that I have up on the channel is how to make bacon out of rice paper. It's simple, super easy to do. It doesn't take you any longer than opening up your package of bacon and frying it in the pan. It takes basically the same time and you're getting your fresh rice paper bacon. It's really good. It's not exactly like bacon, but the planet and the animals are worth so much more than the taste and texture in your mouth. It's not benefiting your body anymore, maybe giving you some cholesterol, maybe giving you some parasites if it's not cooked properly. But there's a lot of pros and cons. Really, though, the planet, the animals, and your own health is worth it. You should go vegan.